What is up, you beauties? It is BatchatBegins, back again, bringing you another fantastic set of replays. Today, we are comparing the E50M and the Leopard 1, the two brothers at the top of the German tech tree line. These tanks could not be any more different if Wargaming tried. The E50M is the medium tank bully, the all-arounder, while the Leopard 1 focuses mostly on mobility and that fantastic gun that it has. We'll be taking both of these tanks out on different maps. First replay here is of myself on Mayan Ruins, and we're just going to go over some of the strengths and weaknesses of both tanks so that you guys can get a good grasp of what you're grinding towards. Before we continue with the replay, if you are new to this channel, make sure to go ahead and like and subscribe. Comment what tank you would like to see below in the next review, and we're going to go ahead and get into this replay on Mayan Ruins. So what are some of the strengths of the E50M? Well, it's got to be that armor. This is one of the most heavily armored tanks at tier 10 for the mediums, meaning that this thing can absolutely bully anything it's coming up against on the flanks that it's going to be going towards. As you can see, this Leopard 1 stood absolutely no chance of facing us frontally on, because not only are we ramming him, we are also putting in that effective DPM while he is forced to shoot HE back at us. And ramming, as I mentioned, is another thing that this tank absolutely excels at. All that armor means that this thing has a ton of weight to it, and with that semi-decent power-to-weight ratio, this thing can put the hurt on lightly armored tanks. You see a light tank or a lightly armored medium tank, you go ahead and ram him, you're dealing between 300 to 400 damage, possibly even more depending on the speed that you ram him at, and then they're bouncing off you, and you're absolutely decimating that flank. Another great thing about the E50M is it has very, very good maneuverability to go along with that great power to weight ratio and the weight of the actual tank, meaning that not only is ramming very effective, but repositioning can be very effective in this tank as well. Now, maneuverability is certainly a strength for this tank, but it does not have the best power to weight ratio out of all these medium tanks, so it does struggle from time to time to get up to that top speed, meaning that you should keep this in mind when you're trying to reposition, flank, or run away from an enemy team. You aren't going to be going at 60 kilometers immediately. It will take you some time to get there, so keep that in mind with your retreat plans or your repositioning plans. Now, let's talk a little bit more about the downsides of the E50. I just mentioned repositioning and how the power to weight needs to be kept in mind when you're looking at taking this tank on a flank, but you also need to be aware that the penetration is not fantastic if you are not running calibrated shells. Another thing to take a look at is the armor. Now, I know what you're saying, Bat Chad, you mentioned that the armor was a strength. Well, yes, the hull armor is an absolute strength, but the turret can be penetrated by high penetration TDs and heavy tanks. It has those flat turret front sides that you do not want to be exposing very often in a brawl. So you want to try to keep this thing wiggling, maneuverable, so that it's much harder to hit those weak spots. Now, let's just go over some of the ways you can put the E50M in a successful scenario. You need to group up with your heavies or your mediums and try to wolfpack the enemy. As we are doing here, you can see we are not splitting up. We are dealing with this IS-7 3-on-1 and ignoring the T-62A to deal with him later. Rushing isolated tanks with overwhelming numbers is a very common comp tactic that you will see from time to time in quick tourneys or in Twister Cup, and you'd be very wise to take note of why that is an important tactic. It is because you are out DPMing the enemy by 3-to-1 at that point, and you can move from target to target. They're going to find it a lot harder if they are splitting their focus fire between multiple targets while you and your allies are focusing a singular target down with all of that combined DPM. And the great thing about the E50 is it combines that mobility, armor, and gun handling to be a very effective spearhead for a wolfpack tactic. Now, we've taken a look at the E50M, but let's swing on to the other side of the German medium tank tech tree at tier 10 and take a look at a tank with no armor but an incredibly devastating gun. Now, playing the Leopard 1 for us today is Chromie from the Void Clan. If you guys want to send in a replay for me to feature and commentate over, the link is in the description for my email, or you can message me on Discord. But moving on into the Leopard 1, what are the strengths of the tank? Well, first off, it's got to be said, it is that laser-accurate gun. This thing is going to be able to hit snapshots, it's going to be pinning weak points from a good long distance, or even if you're in a knife fight brawl, you're going to be able to hit your shots. As you can see, Chromie does not have to take his time aiming like you would with, say, a 121 or some other 105mm gun at tier 10. Instead, he can just poke out, take a shot, and there is a very high chance that that shot is going to penetrate the enemy tank. Another upside of the Leopard 1 is that fantastic mobility, able to cap out at 65 kilometers per hour, and with a fantastic power to weight ratio to get up to that speed, you're going to be able to flank and reposition at your heart's content during the battle. The last real upside of the Leopard 1 is the gun depression. Now it has 9 degrees of gun depression, which is a little bit frustrating when tanks that have good turret armor like the M48 Patton and the STB-1 get that 10 degrees of gun depression. But I digress. Let's move on into some of the downsides for the Leopard 1. Now, it's got to be said, the biggest downside of this tank is the fact that it has zero armor whatsoever. You are going to get penetrated almost all the time right through the gun mantlet in the turret, and you're going to get HE'd pretty much all over the tank. The sides are a weak point for HE, the rear is a weak point, and for tank destroyers, they can go right through your lower plate when you are sitting on flat ground. Now, the unfortunate downside is that even with your fantastic DPM, because you can get HE'd, you are often out-traded if you are not very careful with your positioning for this tank. Now, another massive downside for the Leopard 1 is the fact that it has absolutely zero gun depression over the rear of the tank, meaning that if anybody gets behind you, you are often finding yourself shooting into strong turrets while not being able to shoot weaker hulls. So for instance, if that 62A that's in front of Chromie now was to get behind him, he would have to shoot at the 62A's turret, which is not very consistently pinned, even with heat. Now let's get into some of the ways that you can make your Leopard 1 succeed in the majority of your battles, and that is to keep an eye on your minimap and try to isolate targets on the enemy team. Because the Leopard 1 does not excel in brawls, you are trying to put your DPM to use on a single target. Now, this IS-4 is a perfect example of that. Chromie can use this hill in order to bait shots from the IS-4, and then he can effectively out-trade the IS-4 on his reload. Now, that is the really important thing with the Leopard, is you want to try to not be the focus of the enemy team. Because even though you have that DPM, you will often get out-traded if you're in more than a 1v1 scenario. So you want to try to be the pest while other people are taking the focus fire of the enemy team. It is a very simple tactic. You stay patient until your team takes the aggro away from you, and then you're able to deal with the tanks that are not focusing you, and you're putting all of your effective DPM to use at that point. And with all that DPM on a target on a flank that is not paying attention, you are able to quickly whittle down the HP pools of everybody that is on that flank, which will ultimately change the tide of a losing battle. And this isn't specific to the Leopard 1 or any medium tank, but aggression management is very, very important in this game. It is being aware of your HP and knowing when you can be aggressive on enemy tanks. Chromie took a look at his HP. He saw that he had enough HP to go ahead and get behind the Jagdpanzer, even if he had to take one shot. So he went ahead and isolated the last remaining tank on the red team. And he's going to go ahead and secure the 6.5k gain. Guys, I really hope you enjoyed this video on the two top tier German medium tanks. I'll have some more German tank videos coming out this week just to show you how to play this very, very unique branch within World of Tanks Blitz. All the social links will be down in the description, whether you want to join the Discord or send me a replay. I hope you guys will like, subscribe, comment what tank you'd like to see next, and I will see you guys in the next one. I still see your shadows in my room. Can't take back the love that I gave you. It's to the point why I love and I hate you, and I cannot change you, so I must replace you. Easier said than done.